Hi, and welcome to the BioCompare Video Bench Tip. As always, our video bench tips are a chance for us to talk about new developments in the tools and technologies available to life science researchers. Today, we're going to be focusing on high-resolution melting, or HRM for short. It allows you to rapidly perform single nucleotide polymorphism or point mutational analysis, zygosity testing, and even epigenetic analysis. With traditional techniques, following DNA amplification, the sample is loaded on a matrix or a gel for electrophoresis, DHPLC, mass spec, or array analysis to separate and detect any changes. With HRM, following target amplification, a melting step under high-resolution conditions enables SNP detection or discovery in the same run, saving both time and money. So how does HRM work? Well, the analysis relies on the presence of a saturating double-stranded DNA binding dye during the thermal denaturation of a double-stranded DNA amplicon and an extremely well-controlled thermal denaturation profile. The dye intercalates into the double-stranded DNA helix structure in a base pair-dependent manner and fluoresces strongly only when intercalated. After amplification in the presence of the dye, the DNA products are briefly melted and then allowed to reanneal. This results in the production of all possible homo and heteroduplexed amplicons. The gradual remelt of these amplicons reveals the differences in the base pairing of amplicons by changes in the shape of the melt profiles. So what do you need to do to set up an HRM experiment? Well, it requires a saturating non-inhibitory double-stranded DNA binding dye, a high-performance PCR instrument, and data analysis software. Amplicon melting temperature differences between a wild type and a mutant are in the range of 0.2 to 0.5 degrees, so an instrument used for HRM should have a very low delta temperature across the entire block. The critical components of experimental optimization include the primer design, sample preparation, reaction optimization, and data analysis. A major advantage of HRM is the ability to scan for mutations without the need for sequencing. HRM allows any amplicon to be screened for unknown variants. Allele-specific primers or probes are not required. HRM can also be used as an alternative to next-generation sequencing for methylation analysis. In the presence of controls and standards, the percent methylation of experimental samples can be determined based on melting curve analysis and melting temperature changes in the sequence of interest. For high-throughput analysis, HRM is a cost-effective genotyping technology delivering fast and robust results.